Welcome to the market wrap for Thursday, the 25th of January. Well, it's been another gain for the Aussie market. The US share market just continues to hit record high after record high, and that's exactly what we saw last night again, and that definitely propelled what we saw in the Aussie market today. So we did end the session about 0.5% higher, 36 points to 7,555. That was our fifth straight session of gains, and that means in the past 4 days, we've made an improvement of close to 2%. We're also getting closer to our own record high here in Australia, now just around 1% away. So it could just be a matter of a few good days to potentially get us there. So I guess we'll have to wait and see what happens. It was only a few weeks ago that we were testing a record high, but couldn't quite get there. We're just 0.1% away. So I guess we'll wait and see what happens going forward. Now, looking over to sector performance today, 6 of the 11 entered in positive territory. Miners led the gains for a second day and managed to snap 3 straight weeks of declines, with the prospect of stimulus coming out of China driving those improvements. Energy coming in as second best, healthcare up there too, but some of the worst performers were real estate and tech, both down around 0.4% today. Now onto some of today's winners. Fortescue reported a 6% lift in iron ore shipments over the quarter, and it also left its guidance unchanged. That led its shares about 2% higher. Similar story with Mineral Resources, who posted a 23% lift in its iron ore shipments, pushing its shares higher to be today's second best. Sleep apnea company ResMed ended in third position on the back of an earnings beat. And Incitec Pivot, that's the company that deals in explosives and fertilizers, well, it came out with some good news for its investors today, saying they'll be returning about $500 million back to its shareholders. On to some of today's worst performers, though. Domino's Pizza performed worse by far, down by over 30% and hitting its lowest level since mid-2019. That's after withdrawing its full-year guidance, flagging slower-than-expected sales growth in some of its markets, including Japan and Asia. Sayona Mining is the latest lithium miner to announce that they'll be conducting a review in order to cut costs, amid lithium prices being under quite a bit of pressure. Of course, they did slump about 50% in 2023, and it was only just on Monday that we heard a similar story from Liontown. So it does certainly seem to be a trend in the lithium space at the moment, under pressure with those falling lithium prices. And Core Lithium was today's worst performer after a disappointing exploration update. On to currencies, the Aussie dollar sits roughly flat at 65.7 US cents, firmer against the other currencies there, including the Kiwi, the yen, the pound, and the euro. Now, looking ahead, of course, it is a holiday-shortened week here in Australia, so tomorrow the Aussie market will be closed for the Australia Day public holiday, but US markets will remain online. And importantly, out of the US, we will get an important update on inflation coming out on Friday night. So, of course, our market here won't have a chance to respond to that or what happens in US markets until Monday. Now, plenty of things going on next week as well. So in the US, we have the latest on their jobs. Reporting season will continue to ramp up as well. We have a lot of those big names and some of the biggest companies listed over in the US releasing their latest profit results, including Amazon, Apple, Meta, Alphabet, and Microsoft. So that could really drive what we see in US share markets and also Aussie markets next week. And finally, that quarterly inflation update here in Australia, that's the one we've been waiting for. That could impact what the RBA decides when they meet the following week. So all eyes will be that on that when it comes out on Wednesday. On that note, enjoy the long weekend and we will be back here on Monday. Bye.